sure looks like it's there with respect to at least a couple of those episodes of the program.
Wait,
apologize for having hired him years ago as a district U.S. attorney. I'm very embarrassed about that. I don't know if it's in the Jim Comer. But, you know, today's revelation by John Solomon is a blockbuster. I mean, it was clear to the State Department that the Steele dossier was a complete phony. The memo was circulated. If he didn't read it, he was mistaken. And, you know, I read part of that dossier, and I've done this project stuff for years. The day when it first started. If you can't figure out that the Steele dossier is a piece of junk, then you shouldn't be the FBI director. I have no doubt that he's got a serious problem having put his name on that affidavit and not revealed that it was unverified, not revealed that he took no steps to verify it. But the State Department employee was able to figure out that Steele lied about there being a consulate in Miami for the Russian government. That Steele lied. He hadn't been in Moscow. He'd been in Russia for 9 years.
Well, why did they keep using it? Why did the FBI continue to lie to Christopher Steele, even after he broke the deal in the late summer, it was August 2015, and he couldn't talk to the media? He broke the deal. He was deemed unreliable. But then it looks like they still kept using the fruits of his labor with this dossier.
Yeah, and also...
And him?
During that period, Comey never attempted to verify it. He had 5 months to do it. When he went to the president in early January of 2017 and said it's unverified and salacious, he had 5 months to verify it. If he had verified it, he would have found out very easily that there are 5 areas that were absolutely untrue. And he never revealed to the court what he was paid for. Political document.
Create a foreign interference, throwing the Ukrainians and the Russians and Jews.